My name is Jillian Steelman, and I am an educator. I've been in education for over 20 years. I've been a teacher, both a special education teacher and a general education teacher. And although I have taught all subject matters and I've integrated literacy into the different content areas, I am really a literacy and reading specialist, as well as a writing specialist. I come from Randolph, New Jersey, and I live there with my husband, Chris, my daughter, Alexandra, and a very mischievous four-year-old blue-nosed pit bull terrier. His name is Mateo. So, thank you for this opportunity to tell you a story. I wish I had a book with me, but I do not, so I'm going to just give it a try and tell you the story of the Emperor's New Clothes. So once upon a time, a long, long time ago, there was an emperor, and this emperor loved clothes. He loved clothes so much that that's all that he concentrated on were the clothes that he was going to wear. He changed his clothes every single hour, and a lot of times he would not attend meetings or see people unless he had time first to change his outfit. One day, two men came into the emperor's city and said that they were weavers of the best kind, and that they could weave him an outfit made of golden thread and beautiful silk, and it would be an outfit unlike any other outfit in the whole world. Of course, the emperor was really happy about that, being a lover of clothing. And he agreed to have these two men weave him the beautiful garments or clothes. So he gave them a lot of silk and lots of money and golden thread for them to use to weave him the garments. And he even gave them a special place to work in. They told him also something that was very important to him. They told him that only very smart, intelligent people would be able to see these clothes, and that it would be a great way for the emperor to tell if those people who were working for him directly, the ministers and those people that were helping him run the kingdom, were smart enough and intelligent enough to do their jobs. Because if they were not smart enough or intelligent enough to do their jobs, they would not be able to see these beautiful garments. That really got the king interested in having them. He wanted them more than ever. So he told them they could have whatever they needed in order to make these garments for him. Well, one day he was wondering about what was going on with the garments. He really kind of wanted to see how much work they had done. He was very excited. But he was also a little bit afraid, and he thought to himself, so what if I can't see those garments? What if I go to see them and I'm not able to? That will mean that I am not as intelligent or as ready to be the emperor of this city as I think I am. So, the emperor decided that he would send his highest minister, the man he knew who was the most intelligent man, other than himself, in his kingdom. So he sent the minister off to check on the progress of the clothes. Well, when the minister got there, the two men had heard he was coming, and they were all prepared to receive him. They were sitting at the looms, and they were busy weaving, but they weren't really using any materials to weave. When the minister walked into the room, they said to him, "See the beautiful creation that we've made? We've been working very, very hard, and we've made this beautiful cape for the emperor, and we've just got to finish the leggings, his pants, and his shirt, and the rest of the garments. But we are well on our way." Well, the minister did not see a thing because there really wasn't a thing for him to see. But, of course, he knew the story about intelligence and being smart enough to do his job, and his job paid him very, very well. And he had a lot of privileges because he had the job that he had, and he was not willing to give those up. So, what do you think he did? Of course, he pretended he could see those garments. And of course, the two men went right along with him, showing him the different garments and the beauty of them and how finely woven they were. And he acknowledged them, saying, "Oh, yes, they are the most beautiful garments I have ever seen." And so he went back and he told the emperor of the weaver's progress, and he told him the garments were so beautiful. So some time went by, and still the emperor did not yet have his garments. So he decided once again to send somebody else to go see them. And what do you think happened that time? Of course, the same exact thing. For that person did not want to admit that they weren't as intelligent or weren't as capable to fill their position that they had. And so they went back to the emperor and they told him the same story, that the garments were beautiful and that they were almost finished, and that soon they would be able to have a fitting for the emperor and he could try on all the clothes. The emperor was so excited, he could not wait, and he planned this huge celebration for the day that he could reveal this beautiful clothing to his people and his community. So one day, finally, the two weavers came to the emperor and they said they were ready to have a fitting. And so the emperor took off all of his clothes, and these two men pretended to put on these beautiful garments on the emperor. And of course, those people who he had sent to see them were telling him how beautiful the garments were and how stately and regal they made him look. And so he was very, very proud to have those garments. The weavers told him they just had to finish up a few things to make sure that they fit perfectly. And they needed a little bit more golden thread and a little bit more silk. And so, of course, the king gave them anything that they wanted so they could finish that up. And they went back. Several days later, they came back with the beautiful garments. And they had to help the king put the garments on. They pretended that they were tying the bows and buttoning the buttons and fixing the cape behind him. And the emperor said, "I am ready. I'm ready for the celebration of these garments, and I'm ready for the parade." And so he called his greatest horses forward and his greatest carriage to ride on. And he went outside. And he climbed on the carriage, and his driver started to pull the horses through the streets for the parade. And he started to look around, and at first, everybody had very serious looks on their faces. They were looking at each other, wondering whether or not the people next to them could see these garments, because they couldn't. But then, all of a sudden, they all realized that the emperor was naked. That's kind of silly, right? But he was a silly guy. And he was riding through the streets naked, and they all began to laugh at him, which made the emperor absolutely furious. And he asked, "Well, why? Why is everybody laughing at me?" And a little boy ran up to him and said, "Ha, ha, ha, you're naked!" And the emperor was furious because he realized that he had been stolen from. And so he set out his armies and his troops to find these two men. But they were long gone, carrying with them bolts and bolts of beautiful silk fabric and golden thread. And money that they could use somewhere else and sell and be rich for the rest of their lives. The end. Thank you for letting me share that with you. I also wanted to tell you that I do have a master's in education. I am certified in the United States in elementary education and special education. And I also have a certification in supervision and administration. I am a curriculum developer right now, but I've worked in the public school environment as both teacher and administrator. I hope to hear from you all soon. Take care.